Welcome student in our today's section of subject hydraulics and pneumatics. Today we are going to take another chapter, which is chapter number 5, and its name is pneumatics. So let's start from this pneumatic system here. So this is the pneumatic system. It is the system which is using the fluid in form of air. So here in place of this hydraulic fluid we are going to use the air, that's why we name it as pneumatic system. Okay, so here you can see on your screen. Pneumatic system is a power transmission system in which transmission of power takes place through compressed air. So here we are going to use the air. How this it is, we are going to use the mechanical energy of compressors, mechanical energy compressor, then this compressor compresses the air, then it is the flow of energy through the pipes or pipes and valves, etc. Then it moves to the actuators, and after actuator we get the mechanical energy. So here in actuator we convert the energy of this air into the mechanical energy. I already show you how the actuator in chapter number 2. Okay, so here you can see on your screen. Mechanical energy is given to the compressor, that is shaft of compressor is rotated by means of the prime mover. Compressor draws air from atmosphere and the compressed air flow to the actuator through pipes and valves. Actuator produces back the mechanical energy, either linear motion or cylinder or rotary motion of the air shaft. So here it is the general layout of pneumatic system. So what contains in the general layout? It is having the so this is the general layout of this air compressor. So in it, what is the main important parts? The important parts is we took air from this atmosphere, then it moves to the air dryer, where the any water particle contains in that air is get dried there or eliminated there inside the air dryer. Then this air is moved to the receiver tank, where the high pressure air is get stored there. Then it is moved to the FRL. Full form of F is filter, R for regulator, and L for lubricator. Then all this moves to the actuator. It's a double acting cylinder, or you may call it as a actuator, because here the energy of air is get converted into the mechanical energy. And we control the motion of this actuator by using this direction control valve. Here 4x2 direction control valve is used. Okay. So this is the general layout of this pneumatic system. Here again, components of pneumatic system. First compressor is air compressor. It is draw the air from atmosphere, compresses it and deliver compressed air to the pneumatic system. Second component is air dryer. Third component is air receiver tank, where the high pressure air is get stored there. Then fourth one is FRL unit, filter, regulator and lubricator. Inside the lubricator, lubricating oil is mixes with the compressed air. Then this is the direction control valve. It controls the direction of the flow of compressed air, by which it performs extension and retraction of the actuator. Then flow control valve. It controls the rate of flow of compressed air, by which the speed of extension or retraction of actuator is controlled. And here double acting cylinder, it is the form of the you can see it is as the actuator here. Then factors to be considered while selecting the component of pneumatic system. So these are the factors listed below are the we need to be considered while selecting the components. First one is the operating pressure, then flow rate of compressed air, then filter rating of selection of for selection of filters, then stroke length required for selection of cylinder, force required and speed required by the actuator, compactibility and durability, then cost These are the factors we need to consider while selection of the components of pneumatic system. Then port size, pipe size, etc. for connections. Environmental conditions such as temperature and humidity also need to consider while selecting the components. And last one is the surrounding conditions such as chemical, high temperature, it's also taken into account. Then here we are going to see the advantages of this pneumatic system. So pneumatic system are very fast in operation. This is because low viscosity of compressed oil. So as compared with the hydraulic system, this pneumatic system have very high response or very high speed for operation. This is next is pneumatic system can run continuously for a longer period. Harder it runs, cooler it works. In any pneumatic system, the continuous free expansion of compressed air causes chilling effect. Due to this, continuous long run will not heat the system component. Here, if continuous long run will not heat the system, but it will quite happen in the hydraulic system. Pneumatic system works better even in the hot surroundings. The pneumatic system are better in mines because they do not generate any spark and hence no chance of explosion and fire hazards. Pneumatic system is environment friendly. Then return lines are absent, making the circuit simpler. Here the air which moves out from the return lines is directly went to the atmosphere. So the return lines are absent here. Leakage of compressed air does not possess any problem. Expect a reduction in efficiency. Okay, then now we are going to see the disadvantages of this pneumatic system. Force developed by pneumatic system is very less compared to the hydraulic system. This is because the air is compressible in nature and air pressure cannot be increased to high value. Generally, a pressure up to 10 bar is used. So student, keep in mind that whenever you required very high pressure inside the actuator or to develop very high force inside the actuator, you must go with the hydraulic system, because this pneumatic system can be used up to the 10 bar only, but pneumatic system can be used up to the 200 bar or 400 bar also. Air is freely available in nature but not compressed air. The compressed air is very costly. This is due to the various losses of energy during compression, such as heat compression, friction loss, and leakage losses. Then lubricator is required to add lubricant oil to the compressed air. The pneumatic system are noisy unless exhaust port are fitted with the silencer. Precise control of speed is not possible. This is because low viscosity and fast motion of air into the cylinder. So this is the disadvantages of this pneumatic system. Now we are discussing about the application of pneumatic system. So pneumatic tools, various pneumatic tools including drilling machines, screwdrivers and nut runners are works on this pneumatic system and makes the work simple. If you went to some automation industries or some manufacturing industries, many times they are having this pneumatic drilling machine or pneumatic gun, pneumatic screwdriver. Okay, then packing system. Here is the final operation done on products in the industry. Packing should be as fast as possible. Almost all packing machines are pneumatic, uses pneumatic system. Then here in material handling and robotics, we are going to use the pneumatic system. In mining process also, due to inflammable gases involved from earth during mining and due to the presence of explosives in the mines, electrical devices should not be used because the spark produced by them may cause explosion and fire hazards. Hence, pneumatic hand tools are extensively employed in the mines. Then in automobiles, air brakes, air suspension, automatic doors, wipes and cushioning, etc. uses the pneumatic system. Then machine tools, then medicals and dental equipment also uses the pneumatic system along with the agricultural equipment. Then here is a simple difference between the hydraulic system and pneumatic system. This working fluid is hydraulic oil in case of the hydraulic system, and working fluid is compressed air in case of the pneumatic system. As oil is incompressible, oil can be pressurized to very high pressure, means up to 500 bar or even more. But in case of air is compressible, hence air can be pressurized up to the 10 bar approximately. Since here the pressure is high, force develop is also very high. But in case of pneumatic system, pressure is very less, so force develop is also very less. In case of hydraulic system, components are very strong, made of steel and heavy. But in case of pneumatic system, components are lighter in weight and made up of aluminium. Then in hydraulic system, oil has more viscosity and it cannot flow fast. But in case of pneumatic system, air has very less viscosity and it can flow fast. Then due to continuous recirculation, temperature of oil increases. Here, harder it runs, cooler it works, means free expansion of air is in cylinder and motor causes chilling effect. The hydraulic oils are problematic. Petroleum-based oils, they are inflammable, but here no chance of fire hazard in case of pneumatic system. Leakage of oil runs in dirty and slippery surroundings may lead to the accident. Very clean and dry surrounding in maintenance takes place in the pneumatic system. Rest are easy, you can read by yourself. Now here we are going to see the compressors. So application of compressor, what is compressor? Compressor, it is a device which is used to suck the air from the atmosphere and compresses it. So compressor is a machine which draws the air from atmosphere, compresses it and raises pressure and delivers the high pressure compressed air to the air receiver tank. Here you can see it is the symbol for air compressor, the associated with the then application of compressor, supercharging of IC engine, then gas turbine jet, pneumatic system, in spray painting, in mining, in air refrigeration system. You know, in air refrigeration system, VCR, vapor compression refrigeration system. The compressor is heart of this refrigeration system. Okay. Then filling of compressed air tubes. Filling of compressed air tubes of tires of vehicles. Cleaning of workshop machines where we need compressed air, and to produce this compressed air, we need the compressor. Okay. So here we are discussing the things that can be used atmospheric air directly in pneumatic system. If no, why and what should be done to make use of. So here they listed that if you are going to use the atmospheric air directly, then it will be have some moisture in it, some foreign materials in it. So we cannot use this atmospheric air directly here. No, we can't use the atmospheric air directly in pneumatic system. The air may undergo some processes, then we can use it. So first process is compression. Air should be compressed to increase the pressure. Then drying, atmospheric air contain moisture. And we need to remove this moisture, because if moisture comes inside the system, then problem of rusting may cause. Then filtration, air has dust particles, so to remove this, we need filtration, air pressure regulator and lubricators. Adding lubricator oil to the compressed air is done by using lubricator. Look, lubricator is required to for the force-free working of the system. Because if lubricator is present there, then there may be will not be production of the shock waves inside the system. Then here is some classification of air compressor. We already studied this in power engineering, but still it is given here. So compressor is classified into two: dynamic compressors and positive displacement compressor. Positive displacement are further classified into reciprocating and rotary. Rotary compressor classified into root blower, screw, vents and scroll compressor. Here the dynamic compressors are classified into axial and radial. Single stage, multi-stage and radial compressor also are single stage and multi-stage. Look, student, this is the simple topic today that they are asking us, this selection of air compressor for pneumatic system. So which factors or selection criteria for compressor used in the pneumatic system? So here are the following factors are to be considered while selecting air compressor for a pneumatic system. First is average air consumption of air system. Second one is the free air delivery. What is free air delivery? Free air delivery is defined as the volume of air drawn by the compressor per unit time after compression, the volume reduces as per the pressure. Free air delivery is also taken in account while selecting the air compressor unit. Then this air receiver capacity, then power supply is also considered while selecting the air compressor unit. Let's sketch compressed air generation. So how we are going to generate the compressed air? So compressed air generation system components are intake air filter, then interstage cooler, then after cooler, air dryers, then moisture drain traps, receiver, and etc. So here intake air filter, then stage 1, then intercooler is present there, then stage 2. Here the stage 1 means low pressure compression, and this is stage 2 means high pressure compression. After this, coolers, then air dryer, then moisture drain traps, and then it moves to the receiver. So this is the complete compressed air generation here. So first, what is intake air filter? It prevents dust from entering compressor. Dust causes sticking of valves, cord, cylinder, and excessive wears. Then interstage cooler reduces the temperature of air before. Dear student, you know that multi-stage compression is preferred over a single-stage compression, because if you use multi-stage compression, then less work is required to produce the high-pressure compression there. That's why we are going to use the intercooler. So stage 1 is low pressure compression and stage 2 is high pressure compression. Then after coolers, the objective is to remove the moisture in the air by reducing the temperature in water and cool heat exchanger. Then air dryers, the remaining traces of moisture after cooler are removed using the air dryers. The moisture drain traps are used for removal of moisture in the compressed air. The traps are reassembled traps. Various types of traps used as are manual drain, cocks or time-based automatic drain valves, etc. This is the receiver, last component. Here it receives the compressed air. Now we are going to see the typical air distribution system. So this is the diagram for this typical air distribution system. So here entry is of compressed air, then it moves to the filter, then regulator, then lubricator, then it passes to the control valve, then it moves to the actuator, and then it moves to the muffler, silencer, and then it moves to the atmosphere. This is the complete cycle of this compressed air. Okay, this is our air distribution system. So you know, in filter we eliminates the foreign particles contained inside the air. In regulator, we regulate its pressure. In lubricator, we add the lubricating oil with the air. In control valves, we control the direction of this high pressure air. And here in actuator, the energy of this high pressure air is converted to the mechanical energy. Then it is moved to the muffler, silencer, and then it moves to the surrounding. Because if we directly send air from actuator to the atmosphere, then it will causes the sound. To eliminate this sound, we are using here muffler silencers. So air compression distribution system, from air receiver to exhaust port of valve, FRL unit, pipe valves, actuator, etc. are connected through the pipelines. When a compressed air distributor system is properly designed, installed, and operated and maintained, its major source of for industrial power possessing many inherent advantages. So factors considered while designing a good compressed air distribution system are air volume flow rate, air pressure requirement, types of number of compressors, air quality, air system efficiency, air system safety, air system layout. All these are the factors you should be considered while designing a compressed air distribution system. So these are some important definition. First one is the free air delivery. It is defined as the volume of flow rate of air drawn by air compressor from the atmosphere. It is known as free air delivery. Theoretically, free air delivery, it is the LAN upon 60 for single acting cylinder. single acting compressor, and for double acting it is heavy, it is equals to 2 into LAN upon 60. Then piston displacement is defined on the soft volume of low pressure cylinder. In other words, it is the theoretical free air delivery. For single acting compressor, piston displacement is equals to LAN upon 60 meter cube per second. Then this is the compression ratio. Second, then third one is the compression ratio. It is the ratio of volume before compression to the volume after compression. This compression ratio RFC is equals to V1 upon V2. Then this fourth definition is of pressure ratio. It is the ratio of pressure after compression to the pressure before compression. It is equals to P2 by P1. Then third ratio is the temperature ratio. It is the ratio of temperature after compression to the temperature before compression. It is assessed by R of T is equals to T2 by T1. Then isothermal compression. It is defined as the compression in which the temperature remains constant, means T1 is equals to T2 and P1 V1 is equals to P2 V2. And then adiabatic compression is defined as the compression in which there is no heat transfer between the system and surrounding and heat is neither added nor removed, so we name it as adiabatic compression. So students, we are stopping here, and in the next section we will see the further.